So here we're back with our simple bass. And we tried a couple of different things. Now, you might be happy with that. That sounds great. But hold on a second. We've actually got another filter here. So why don't we just turn the mix all the way to the left? Of course, we get nothing because we haven't selected it. So let's bring in all the oscillators. In fact, let's leave the sub oscillator for now. So make sure we've got this selected, the SVF. Turn the cutoff all the way down. Bring up the envelope amount. Sounds all right to me. So let's have a look at the settings for the state variable filter. So we've got 20 hertz cutoff, which is at the bottom. Resonance is 66%. Envelope amount is 47%. Sounds nice and punchy to me. However, what we could do is go and change the key tracking again. Same for the ladder filler. About 50%. On a lot of synths, you either get 50% or you might get a knob or it's 100%. And all that does is make it a bit darker at the bottom, brighter at the top. It's like a tilting table. Now, of course, the way that the state variable filter works is you can either have it as parallel, so two 12 dB filters, because there's actually two in that one, or you can have one going into the other for 24. So let's change it to series. So now we get more into 24 dB territory. That sounds massive, doesn't it? And that's even without the sub. So let's hear it without me clicky clacking. So that's just using two oscillators. Now, let's bring in the third, which is the sub. I think it might be a bit too much. It's such a low frequency, it's not adding tons. So we've still got the modulation that we did before going to the LFO, the vibrato, but we haven't got anything assigned, the X, Y or whatever, to the filter. Now, what I like to do is, so we've got this one bass over for the ladder filter. Well, why don't we use the mod wheel to control like a crossfade, if you like. So we're starting with the ladder filter. Let's go to mod wheel. Let's move the mix all the way over to the left. So then when I go forward with the mod wheel, it will go from the ladder filter to the state variable. And then elements in between. Now, sometimes I'm going all the way over 100% at the moment, so let's hear it. Move the mix now until we start hearing the ladder filter. You can hear it there. And all I'm doing is just shortening that so we get more distance out of this. So done. So now we're using, we've got this ladder filter. Now that one sounds a touch louder actually than the ladder filter. That's because ladder filter's got a bit of resonance on, so it's changing the gain. So we could slightly change the gain if we wanted to when we push forward on that, but for this purpose there's no point. So let's hear this change. Another thing we might want to do is, like we did with the ladder filter, push it forward, and then so we've only got the variable filter, and then we can use the Y again for the cutoff. So let's go Y, cutoff, bring it up a touch. Don't hit done yet. That sounds funky to me. I'm quite happy with that. And then let's have a listen to see what the FM sounds like with this filter. Oh, it's gnarly, that one, isn't it? Let's change the source. We can have a look. Sounds like a bit like a delay. Around there, it seems to bring in a bit of extra low end. Interesting tone. But here, I mean, this is just the state variable, and that sounds bassy enough to me, and it's just two oscillators. Granted, it's unison, but it's using two voices, and we're panning them. What could we do? We could reduce, say, the resonance. Why don't we? I like the resonance going forward on that one. So maybe we'll use the X for reducing resonance. In fact, what I'll do is just turn it positive to the right. So we'll get more. Bit too loud. So again, we can then have a listen to both the sounds, because it is essentially, it's two different sounds. And of course, with all the modulation, you were going through lots of different tones. Remember, we can use the XY hold. So loads of different bass tones. Yeah, they've all got the same shape, but you could do a number of different things. You could assign when you move forward with the mod wheel, you can bring in envelope 3 to change the shape of just one of the filters. There's loads of different things you can do. But the whole point is, A, I think it sounds bassy. You can can make some great bass sounds on. I mean that. It's wicked. And then you can create all these different tones all within one preset. And there we go. There we have it.